This is a really pivotal game, isn't it, to win in a best of five, because you want to have that advantage.
You don't want to be down to one game.
Exactly.
You're out. Yeah, that's huge. I mean, the mental advantage you get from having two in the pocket, you know, you're a game up in this series. If you lose the next one, you're out. You don't want to face that. I mean, the tension there must be unbelievable. Wings are young guys in a new team, so we haven't seen them under that kind of pressure, but neither have we seen DC.
All right, let's get into it. Draft number three.
Welcome back upstairs. We're here at the drafting station getting ready for game three of Digital Chaos versus Wings. We're here to talk drafts, not dabs. That right, Winner?
Yes, Dakota.
Let's do it then. Wings Gaming, they open up with an Oracle, Digital Chaos. They got the Mirana once more, gentlemen. And we await Wings Gaming next pick. So far, things seem stagnant.
Yeah, I just want to mention really quickly that I wasn't actually sold that Wings actually beat the counter to the Void in the last game. I feel it was more just like the Doom not quite piecing it together with the rest of the lineup more than anything else.
What I'm really surprised of, like, nobody's banned the Void. Like, both teams tried to counter the Void, but both teams lost against the Void. Like, why would you not prioritize banning it?
Speak of the faceless.
I mean, if you're Digital Chaos right now, you have to believe in the counter pick, right?
No, you need to pick Naga again. You need to make force it down the
throat. What do you think, Winter?
Do they believe?
I mean, in my opinion, something like Tide is easier to deal with, like, okay. Void. I mean, I'm okay with the Naga, like the way they ran it. You use the song to counter the Chronosphere, but they need something else much more solid to counter initiate. You can't just be defensive all the time. We saw in the first game, Wings, they picked the Pudge. Oh yeah, you save your teammate, but you're not killing up the enemy team.
So they don't go with the counter, they go with the comfort zone pick instead.
But I think this is good, because, you know, it's a move comfort zone pick. And I think in the last game, you know, obviously not much Doom has been played, so giving him a hero that he's going to be able to perform on, especially in the high.
But isn't that one of the heroes that he played a lot in the past?
I mean, it was like what he became known for, but at the same time, he hasn't played it in a while. And I also feel like it's a very different change of pace compared to what he's used to playing.
But it's also a bit difficult for Timber to play against the Void in general. Like, the time dilation really makes the life hard for you. Like, you need Bloodstone, and then you need Lotus Orb, and as offlaner, it's really hard to farm.
But if you get a good lane, then it's easy.
Yeah, of course, if you get a good lane. I just literally think one of the teams should, like, just ban on Void. Like, both teams always try to counter it, and they just can't.
But I don't really think it's that difficult to deal with Void, though, honestly.
No, I don't think so either, but, you know, we'll see what they have in store for us, I guess. We saw the Shadow Demon ban.
Yeah, so we don't have to see Purge talk about it anymore, so that's nice.
Yeah? Game 4. He will talk about it in Game 4.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
What's wrong with you, Dakota?
What?
Hate her.
I love Shadow Demon.
Hate her.
We won't get to see him in
You love Kotal.
Yeah, he's just mad because it's not Keeper.
Yeah.
No, neither team probably.
You will never see Keeper anymore in this series because every game is going to be banned, Dakota. No more. Sorry.
Bold call coming out from Winter here.
But what do we notice? For the first time in a long time, the first two picks are the same for Wings. What happened there?
Great
Maybe
observation.
Taking it seriously?
Great observations.
Taking it seriously?
Yeah, I mean, maybe more so than... Obviously, they like throwing curveballs, but at the same time, I think they want to do that in a position where they're a game up. They don't want to do it in a position where they're tied.
I think it's a reaction to the Mirana. I noticed that they picked Oracle specifically against Mirana.
Of course, like, it's hard counter, we spoke about it before. Yeah. And Void is just like their
a good hero, like a good hero for them.
Yeah.
They could run him off lane, they could run him safe lane. Like, we spoke of this time and time again. You want to have an opening where you can change your lanes if you feel you have to. Like, you don't want to go into the draft like, okay, this hero, you pick a hero that can only go to one position, then it will be difficult to outdraft your and unmaneuver your opponents.
Yeah, I really like the Invoker ban from DC here. Obviously, they would have picked it up again if they could, and they have to pick after the ban, so pretty solid ban there. Banning out the Morphing after that. I guess Void and Oracle, they do have a lot of problems with Morphling.
In general, it's like it. You can never really focus the hero, and that's really a nuisance later on, especially when you get like E-Blade and stuff. Like, yeah, the Oracle kind of counters it with Fade's Edict, but it's more like you get bursted down too quick to be able to save somebody.
And it actually counters Void pretty hard too, because like, Morph is pretty much the only hero that can, like, obviously because of Morph, he can just like survive the Chrono.
Ice Blast.
Yeah, I mean, of course, if you couple it up with Ice Blast, but you know what I mean, right? Like, your Chrono, you usually just die, but Morphin can morph up, and he's like the only hero who can really do that.
How do we feel about maybe Wings Gaming going for Skywrath Mage or something here? Good against the Timber, good with Faceless Void, and it's good for their name.
It's super good.
I would like it. Together with Oracle as well, your Ancient Seal, your nuke deals like 400 damage.
Just perfect, it's their mascot. But no, they say, screw that, we're gonna get a Kunkka.
I mean, Kunkka's also good for like catching these two heroes. Like, DC's opening is very mobile, like Temper Chain and Leap Away. You want something that's gonna be able to start a fight outside of just Chrono. You don't want to play on such a long cooldown, I think, if your Wing's doing it.
Come on, let's be real. Kunkka is just a great hero now.
I mean, yeah, he's just overall really good.
I mean, he is, and they have two setups for him too, like the Fortune's End. Can like disable someone or like freeze someone for 2 seconds, and then you have like the Chronosphere, where it's like really easy to get a boat and a torrent in on top of the like mobility restrictions.
Yeah, they have two really good saves now for the cause. Like, both the supports can keep their cause alive in team fights very well. So for DC, do they go for more bursts, or do they go for like, I guess you might want to consider going for heroes that can kill the supports behind, like run past the front lines, go behind, kill the Oracle first.
I mean, Potom and Timbersaw should be able to do that usually. It's just gonna be like really hard regardless to get there. They have X mark, they have time dilation.
You need stuns, right?
Yeah.
Right now these two heroes are, I mean, Arrow is not so reliable. So you need someone else to initiate for you so you can go in and kill them.
And you don't want to jump in the back of the Potom because, okay, you kill one support, but then you're dead after.
That's a really interesting play.
That was
a fast DP pick.
That was
right
a really fast DP pick. But DP Void, one of the most old school combos, as well as DP Oracle, super good, strong.
So good because of that ult and the soul.
How are they actually going to kill the DP with their heroes? Their last two picks have to have.
No,
like...
their picks are not meant to kill the DP. Because as soon as they saw the Kunkka, they had Void, Kunkka, and Oracle. If maybe DC feels like we're not going to take team fights. Right now we have Mirana with like going for the axe, so you have a lot of deep push, then we have Timber.
Just split push, you mean?
Yeah, then you pick the Wyvern where you have also split push. So you're never gonna be able to take a team fight in the early game.
They just have to make sure
dangerous
then.
Though, right? Like, you can't take a team fight against Wings, you're just gonna take your towers.
Yeah, like DP is just gonna high ground you if you don't wanna fight against them.
It depends how you play around it though, because they are cooldown based, you can always cut the creep wave if you're allowed to, like the AM game where Fear, like he bought his team so much time by cutting the wave, like something like that would be useful against a 5-man lineup.
I would really like
Wings dealt with that super well. Sorry, go ahead.
No, like I would really like to see like a split push style too, but they need to pick a hero that can actually kill objectives too, because right now they don't have any. Timbersaw, Potom, Sand King, they're all really good at clearing waves, but they can't actually hit buildings.
Yeah.
Is this a support Sand King?
DC showing that they have flexibility now.
Yeah, Weeha doesn't want to play it for sure, like the Timber, I mean.
Do we see Mu play Sand King very often? Not really. Right?
I think it's a Misery Sand King.
Yep.
Yeah, that would make a lot more sense.
Soxa, Wyvern, Misery, yeah. Sand King, and Mu on the Timber, so that sounds more likely for DC.
Soxa's Wyvern is out of control good, so.
Is AM too greedy for DC?
AM would be pretty greedy, but they need something like it. They need some split pusher that can also burst like heroes down later on.
No, but if you think about greed, since they're never going to be able to fight anyway, so you just pick a hero that's going to allow you to siege later. I mean, it's greedy in a way, but that's your game plan. Like, you're not going to be able to fight early.
But with that being said, that Kunkka is a pretty hard counter to like heroes like AM.
The setup, yeah.
Yeah, like you X mark him, and you're pretty much dead. Until you have like Mantle Steel or BKB.
Does Slark fit that similar profile?
Slark would definitely fit their heroes a lot more.
It's the same thing. Like,
yeah, that's what I'm saying. Same as AM. Like, he falls in that same problem.
Yeah, pretty much like. Just in general, Kunkka is like always a mobile hero counter. He has always been, like, even more now with the like 8-second X mark.
Yeah, but you're a carry player. Look at their heroes. Like, they have Chronosphere, they have X mark. It's very difficult to play a carrier.
Yeah, it's really difficult. And what you need to do is, you need to get a hero out there. Probably, if you really want to split push, you can pick an AM because he can get out of control really easily if they're focused like on pushing all the time.
But they have a lot of team fight now, though, don't you? Is it possible that they pick a team fight called just fight?
I mean, it's definitely possible. It's just like, how do they kill the DP on top of the Kunkka boat and the Oracle ult? It's like really hard to kill her.
You Barrow Shark Epicenter her and curse the heroes behind.
You could just go full spread damage and just pick Gyro, right?
But Gyro would be beast too. And they ran it before too.
I've seen people go Sven against DP for the burst.
Yeah, the armor.
The armor helps a lot too.
And those are pretty good options.
Yeah, if you want to really team fight them.
You're a lot of melee cores then, I guess, but... Oh no, sorry, Moran is there, fine. We'll have to see though.
I just always feel like Sven against Void is kind of iffy to play. But then you get chronoed and suddenly you're up.
Yeah, but
all the armor's gone.
All the carries are, you know, pretty difficult to handle.
Yeah, of course, but like you're when you're more likely to get chronoed than like let's say Slark or AM.
That's why you got that Wyvern and that SK behind you though, just in case.
Yeah, you need a tank. You basically just need a tank for those two heroes to do their jobs.
There you do. I mean, Timbersaw could kind of like fill in that role, I guess. It's like a difficult choice for DC. Whether they go on like team fight direction or split push direction.
Or somewhere totally different. We have not seen this little guy on the main stage, that's for sure. I mean, Bone Fletcher comes out.
But that's kind of what Winder and I spoke about before. It's like, they want to have the split push hero that can also kill objectives really fast, and Kling's definitely fits the category.
The other thing too is, Oracle is not particularly good against that kind of hard carry.
Yep,
Ghost Scepter. He deals insane damage.
You need Ghost Scepter as the Oracle, yeah. So you don't have to use your ultimate to save yourself, and you're able to survive against the Kling's.
He pretty much solves all their problems. Like, yep. He can get to the back line as well.
Yeah. It's like a super good pick. Like, how would Wings respond? Do they need another core mid that is good against bottom and mid, like lineup as a whole? Oh no, they have TP. What am I talking about?
Offlane
or carry?
Probably offlane.
Yeah, they usually run carry void on Shadow.
Nyx Assassin
offlane. It's good.
Good against Timber, obviously.
Good against Wyvern too.
I feel like that lane's incredibly hard for him though.
Oh yeah, that Klings against any offlane is like terrible.
Alright, final thoughts on the draft?
My heart is with Wings.
Your heart is with Wings.
My heart is with Wings.
I'm gonna go against, I'm gonna say DC.
And Draskal has no heart. So let's go ahead and throw it down to the casters right now. We got Toby Wan and Merlini.
Thanks, we got a lot of heart down here. It's a heart that loves Dota 2 and has drawn up series 1-1 apiece, Merlini.
Who's your heart rooting for?
My heart roots for great Dota 2. It always
That's
has.
A cop out.
It always
Get
will.
Out of here, Toby.
I don't care about a cop out. As long as I have terrific Dota, I don't care, and an Enigma.
Maybe one of these games, Toby.
One of them. Just one. Just like one. That'll be fine. All right, let's get into it, man. DC, they're bringing in the Klinks. He's a man, the draft panel where they were asking for someone that's able to fight, but someone also that can push towers down, Klinks. He sort of ticks those boxes.
Yeah, and he's much more resilient than the mobile carries, like the AM, those split pushers that you think of that Kunkka's really good against. I really like the draft.
How long do you keep resolution farming on the Klinks? Do you want him to early rotate? Do we look for the early Orchid build into, like, hero kill rotations?
It all depends on how much they can keep the Nyx Assassin down. Nyx Assassin, they did not go the Iron Talon laning strat this game on Wings.
Yay! They still won with it.
Just the mind game.
I'm just gonna throw that one out there, that even though we're sitting there going, we don't understand why this isn't working. Actually, no, we understand why it isn't working, but they still take the game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm interested to see the timing of resolution.
I also like the Klinks a lot because it gives them Roshan potential. I think they had a lot of issues with that in the prior game.
Are you still concerned about what the Oracle can bring? We've seen Oracle working beautifully with Death Prophet in the past. Now you've also got potential saving from, I say, from Kunkka, from Void Chronos. That's an interesting timing for a smoke too.
It's just really great versus the Mirana because it's really difficult to stop her Axe timing. And this way you don't really have to worry about it so much. A double Starstorm, if you get the Fate's Edict out on time, it's not going to do any damage.
This movement from Wings, they smoked up underneath the tower as the Foghorn was going. They're going to make a break for the side shot. Now, a lot of the time, Misery, he's walking over towards this. He's going to reveal the smoke. So they start with the Fortune's End. Eyesight is there. He's waiting for the Fortune's End to connect. Now they go into the torrent. Misery up into the air. Fire Strike to Babel. Goes up into the tree line. There's a small path to get out, and Fate's trying to block it. He's actually got himself a stun of Babel. Resolution turns on the damage. Misery will escape. Saskar does actually have his defensive Cold Embrace. Another turret will fly in. Resolution, Fortune's End will connect. Misery lining up for another Bar of Strike. Double stun on that one. Faith dropping down very, very low. Misery doesn't have the damage, and he also doesn't have the life to stay on the front lines. They look for another torrent. Nope, Ice Ice just started the animation, but he didn't follow through. So Wings trying to get aggressive and contest this safe lane until they TP their support quickly down to bottom lane.
This is something that we see out of the team fight. Just don't give them an easy lane up top, and Sokka and Resolution are having a very difficult time dealing with.
Oh, that helps.
Double melee.
Fu just got time locked on the bottom lane. Combine that with the Fortune's End. Mood's gonna go down. First blood, it goes to Wings.
And on the top lane.
Yeah, Misery's rotating her out. Fate so low. Resolution lower. Cold Embrace is still available. Now Misery will arrive. Ice Ice. Fire Strike is just going for the last swing. Trying to find Resolution, but these searing arrows doing the early damage that DC required. That arrow fly down. There she is. Resolution will find himself a kill.
And all three of these heroes are very, very low. They're going to have to come in a lot of resources unless they want to suicide. Misery will spill blood to the Centaur.
That he will. And he looks at movement speed. Windlace and TP scroll. He'll come straight back out to the lane. Look for another rotation to fight.
Wings like doing this. They like... It looks bad because they both die, but they have to expend so many resources, so much HP.
We're just going to be careful. They're going to go again on him. He walks over. Such a simple combo. Fortune's End into Tarim. We throw it on the top lane. Now bottom lane, he has reactive armor this time around, but still no Timber Chain available. So move. Poor man's shield will not save you from that.
He thought he was in a one-on-one situation, and then he skilled up for this one-on-one build with the level 1 Whirling Death, a Whirling level 1 reactive armor. In a very defensive situation, you want to max your Timber Chain, but... With that, might be time to think about that Iron Talon.
Now, this has been a heavy rotation early game, only 2 minutes into it. We've seen multiple lane switches. The one lane which hasn't really had anything happen in it is that mid lane. It's the Weeha versus Blink lane. The Mirana on Death Prophet.
Ezreal smoked up behind, looking for a stun into an arrow. It's only a level 1 stun though, but Blink's so far out with no Spirit Siphon.
And you still got the Starfall available too, so Weeha connects on this. Now into that Starfall, the Torrent! The secondary star! It connected on Blink! So he does fall down.
And he does have this bottle, but he needs someone to pull him a TP scroll if he wants to get back to the mid lane. He also had a waste of fairy fire for that.
And Misery is not giving up on this mid. It's a little bit different though when he runs an Ogre. Ogre is a lot tankier than the SK, so I'll give some extra respect as Ice comes into mid. Nice Torrent, Weeha! He's got Leap available, pounces himself away. Will bottle and salve up quickly as Misery's rotated to the top looking for Faith Bian.
And in the meanwhile, Timbersaw finally gets a space in the bottom lane, going for two reactive. Screw the Timber Chain, he says. I can just tank up.
I'm wondering if this is one of the other reasons why you're seeing rotations heavily into mid. They're trying to pull the attention of Wings off that bottom lane to give Move the space he needs.
And Move still has a lot of regen. I don't know if they're going to be able to press him down. No clarities on the Oracle, and he's only level 2.
They got help though. Ice looks to come in from the rear.
I still don't think they have enough damage.
Do you like this build coming out from the Conqueror going the early point up in Tidebringer as opposed to X marks the spot?
We see this a fair amount when the Kunkkas want to go Armlet first and farm up. It's just a good way to keep up your farm so that you're not heavily reliant on the X-Torrent combo to get kills and accelerate your farm. But I think they have enough setup. I really dislike it if you don't have any setup, but with Nyx stun, Chronosphere, Oracle Fortune's End, it should be pretty easy for him to land with the Torrent.
Oh, Misery's coming back down to the mid. There's still no Observe Wars that sees it, but Ice sitting on the high ground. He'll definitely see Misery. Now he puts down his own Ops. Right. It's not something he needs to see Misery anymore. He'll hit him with a Torrent. Over they come. Guru Siphon, Fire Strike, a Fable. He'll actually get a double stun thanks to Yarrow also connecting on Blink. And the combined up Starfall, Misery will back out. Trigger is salve. So just a trade-off of damage. No kills coming from that.
You need to be careful. Ball. He still has the Arcane Rune on him. Getting a lot of value out of that.
And in reality, he already had the Arrow Leap and everything else back up, not to mention the low cost.
Moose's been stacking at this large camp. Shadow's gonna pull it, but we could see a small contest for it in the bottom lane. It's a 3-stack now.
Well, it will be easy for Moose to deal with that if he was level 6, but doesn't have the Chakram available yet. Another heavy rotation to top 3 from either side. They summon Resolution, Karin as well. Sasha, he needs to get that Cold Embrace off, but Oracle has more than a magical damage. Misery with the Barrow Strike forward, wants the Nyx Assassin, doesn't have the damage output, but maybe with the help of the Wyvern, he will have it. Misery to the tree line. The South is actually going to get cancelled off. It was the Caustic Finale that did it, and now Faith, 28 life. Will it be enough? Is he going to pop? Faith barely survives, dropping down to 8 at one point. And Wings, the rotation works from them.
Wow, that was so close. Man, that South tick. Really saved him there.
Resolution wants a kill on top lane, however. Ice doesn't have anything to play with. No mana, Resolution, Searing Arrows, and Strafe will take one more, and there she is. Resolution, a good answer back, and an overstaying of welcome from Ice.
One thing about DC's draft too is they pick a Winter Wyvern perhaps maybe a little bit too early, expecting a lot of physical damage out coming from Wings, but their midcore especially doesn't really do that much.
Moving for Wii, don't know how this kill's really meant to work. He can easily leap away from Crypt Swarm and as well as the Spirit Siphon. No point up in silence yet for the Death Prophet. And I said focusing more on laning as Innocence actually roams around the back line. Now it is nighttime, so DC had no idea that he moved that way. And Weeha right next to him, starting with the Sun Fortune, then as well the Tarn. If it wasn't that, it was going to connect with the Purifying Flames from Innocence. And that's what found the kill.
And that Observer Ward just scouting him out the whole time. Soxa in there, but he can't really do anything. It's level 2 Splinter Blast, but that's going to do little in the way to stop their foot drops an Observer Ward behind. Doesn't look like it was scouted out by Wings' own Observer Ward.
They need TP support, but from Moon, you don't have any real big ultimates up yet. You don't even have the Chakram, so Moon will walk in. Now, Ice can wrap around the back of him. As he's just trying to go for the kill on the Death Prophet, they can't hold her in position. The arrow will fly out from Wii, but easily dodge because you can see it coming from a mile away.
No level 6 yet on Mood. There's no chance of them getting that kill. Not really that much damage on the tower, though, so Wing's not really getting that much out of there. First Exorcism Radiant has used Scan, expecting a smoke perhaps.
I think they were expecting a rotation from Resolution, and they are right, but he walked out of the Obs and Sentry in mid lane. That was after the Dust and the Scan was used. Well,
there is a Dust on the Oracle in case they want to. Oh,
the arrow off target. If that hit, Resolution still can't find the kill. He doesn't have enough damage to kill off the Death Prophet in time.
They don't actually have the Fate's Edict on the Oracle, so he can't disarm the.
Oh, top lane, Misery. Nice Sandstorm dodge. They put down their own Sentry Ward. Cold Embrace will pull him out. The Sandstorm with Faith Yen. Baris Dry cancels the TP out. Digital Chaos. They're looking for that kill. Misery dropping down low. Fate doesn't have much to work with because Stick charges in 1 second. He's got that up now, and he's actually holding onto them. He won't pop, however. Not while Shadow chases down the Winter Wyvern, but support comes in. It's Resolution. He's running down, looking for the kill over on Fate. Leaving Zuska by himself, underneath his own tier 1 tower. Shadow commits the Chrono Spear, so that won't be available, but Resolution shows himself. Time Walk on cooldown, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, over the tree line and far, far away from DC's line. They run down, but Resolution's not giving up. The arrow will force Shadow a little bit closer towards the tree line, but Innocence is in the neighborhood.
Simple yet effective. What a juke.
While on bottom lane, Mook can finally take out that stack. Ice is leeching a little bit off him. Oh, the Tarrant. Okay, Ice just TP's away.
I'm surprised he didn't go for X, especially considering the heroes that he's up against. Mirana, a Timbersaw. I usually see like one or two levels, but not three like he's committed. But it's nice damage. Maybe they just want to be able to burst people down during Chronosphere combo with that Torrent at, boat later.
What do you think about the build on the Faceless Void? Is Lincoln Sphere really
Dude, he
viable?
Always goes Lincolns.
Like, even in this game, is it really that viable?
They usually go pretty strange items, but that's the only thing that I've seen that's consistent amongst their items. Faceless Void carry Lincolns first almost every game. Good versus Winter's Curse? I guess. Last game is definitely good versus the Doom. This game, yeah, I don't agree with it so much, but they like it a lot.
Nice detection from Resolution. He was just hovering around the tree line. And Nyx Assassin walks through a sentry ward while Resolution still had vision. And this is the reason now why Misery hiding behind his own tier 1 tower. But Nyx has moved into the mid lane instead, looking towards Weeha. Not going to find an opening. The Vendetta Rush is going to wear out in a second.
They saw him with the Observer Ward though. He thinks he's in the fog, but he actually was not. And perhaps they might spring a trap for Fate. And the Klinkz isn't actually going for the Oracle because he assumes he has the disarm, but little does he know he doesn't have disarm and he's probably not going to pick it up until level 8. So he's kind of been walking around with a get out of jail free card even though he shouldn't be.
Resolution steals the regeneration rune right in front of Blink, and Blink is just like, wait, I didn't pick that up, it's not inside my bottle, what the hell's going on? It's the skeleton warped Klinkz with that casual Blightstone early on. Trying to find the extra damage. Klink's very, very good at bringing down tier 1 towers.
He's been running around a lot though and hasn't really been able to find that much. He was really doing really well in terms of the CS, but now he's falling behind in net worth as he struggles to.
Well, nice scan.
Goes up.
They reveal the Nyx Assassin sitting in the tree line.
But they have the ward behind the tower. Wings does.
Mm-hmm.
They don't see Winter Wyvern just yet, but now they'll know there's only two.
Nyx is on the edge of the vision. He's going to walk in range of the tower. Faithru will reveal himself, bottom lane, Chronosphere, overall move, very tactical. Resolution bringing in the damage move, chains up, the Torrent well off the mark, it's Resolution. Skeleton Walk will come off cooldown so he can run himself away. They are out, while Faith gonna find Weeha back behind the tower, dropping down that Ring of Aquila to use one charges, and now the commit. It is the Exorcism going to work. Range, the Radiant Sentry wards up, so they see Wee. He has to leap up to the tree line, Snake Spirit Cypher know exactly where he is, he can't get out this one, the stun will connect. An icicle one from Faith. Finding Wii in the trees.
Wow, look at Wii's farm. He is so under farm. Not only has point booster and then some at this point, but he's about to lose his T1. He's died two times at this point. Each Mirana game coming from them getting worse and worse. Resolution coming around from behind as the TP comes in.
Yeah, they look for that damage. Resolution stunned up, and Misery brings the extra health. Baris rocking forward towards Blink, but the damage is enough. Misery, the Sentry one was still down, so the Exorcism finishes him off.
Oh, they try to kill him right before the exorcism. Returned all that health back to him. And this Winter Wyvern hasn't really been able to do that much. It's great against mass summons and a lot of units that are pushing, but Splinter Blast doesn't really do that much versus a Death Prophet plus one.
Yeah, it hasn't stumped the Wings pickoffs and the push.
Yeah, they're not pushing with units, they're just pushing with a couple heroes in their ultimate, and maybe wishing he had gone for Max Arctic Burn at this point. Still, they're unable to get those combos. Once Winter's Curse come out, easy setup for an Epicenter Pro Strike follow-up. Boo, a lot of trouble.
Yeah, again, they're going for this combination with no X marks, they're not going to drag him back, but now the ship, the rock is on the way, and Moo gets his fill. Weehaw.
Who needs time dilation when you have Bash?
Faith is looking at resolution too. Invis up around the tree line. You'll need to hit him first with the Vendetta, then follow up on the stun. Either that or he waits for the Death Prophet who's rotating up to find this kill. Vendetta will last long enough. That is a level 1 Vendetta.
Blink is Invis. They haven't reserved rewards getting any TPs on top lane, but he thinks he's safe. He thinks he's alone.
Here they go. Resolution. Pop him up. And resolution. He goes Invis, but not in time. They trigger the dust just in case.
Man, that invisibility rune, he might have been a little bit scared. It's like, oh, okay, Nyx plus one can kill me, but if you don't see any heroes, there's no way you can predict that King coming.
Soxa, Shadow jumping in, double chrono misery. He can prep the epicenter. The question is, can he get in range? Wyvern's already down, and now they're running closer. Misery will just walk over. Shadow's still got time walk available, so we can repair all the damage that's done to him. And DC, again, getting kicked off with no rebuttal.
Very patient Chronosphere from Shadow, however, they are lacking a lot of mana on the Kunkka, not enough for that boat. He's going for more of the damage build with the Max Tidebringer with the Phase Boots. And another tower.
Yeah, without the committal of Exorcism, this is a troubling sight when you can't even hold your tier 1s.
Misery looking for a kill, Epicenter.
And with a Timbersane into Sharkram, they commit the MP2. Innocence will walk into the side of it, but now we can just use Fortune's End. Slow down Misery, it will connect the follow-on stun with the Mana Burns by Carapace. The cast is out, it holds Oracle in, and Moo comes in with a Sharkram for False Promise. It will keep Innocence alive as he TP's himself away to safety. Moo still looking for something, actually he's just looking to get the hell out of here. Exorcism is triggered. Put the stun, it's on Moo, and it's gonna be Wings holding the Timbersaur in position. No, the chain up, the last attack from the Death Prophet will find the kill. The support has arrived for DC. They arrive in with a big searing arrow damage. Faith makes a break for the tree line, still alive, triggering does too. So no way for Invis for resolution. Time lock, not gonna be enough from Shadow as Weeha, cold embrace, resolution, the torrent, not gonna connect the double stun. Faith the end, he walks himself out, he walks over, he wants the last finishing move, he won't get it. Ice will finish him. The torrent, it may not be done yet. Soxa set up in towards the air. X marks the spot. You ain't going nowhere apart from down to the briny deep. Faith doesn't have enough for the stun. Spike Harper's up unless he connects over on Misery. He tries to raise Faith. No climber from Shadow Time or forward. Now he finds the kill. More keepy support arriving from DC. Another connected call from Ice Eyes into Misery. Stun, Chakra forward. Moody to turn the tide. This fires Misery. The one charge will keep him back into it. He can go for another Burrow Strike. It's Moo. Time locked for a century. He wants to walk out to the T1 towers. No stuns available from Nyx Assassin, but these ones really playing dividends.
Oh my goodness, what ungodly teamwork coming out from Wings next to that side shop.
It's not over yet. Innocence is coming over the Akrono. It's on Weeha. Innocence brings the damage. Weeha, he is gonna pop like a top. They look for more. Ice. Where is it? The Ice X mark's not gonna hit. They turn around, look to the T1 tower. DC. Do they still try and defend this?
Ice looking for an X from the back.
He hasn't got it. Instead, he was actually signing the animation for the torrent. But this tier 1 tower is gone. DC, no more fight. They push the Clink to the top lane. They need that Desolator done. They need the damage. They need the Blink Dagger on Misery.
There were so many small things in the last fight. The dust triggering on the Clink so that he can't get around.
Has he really done this? The torrent! If it connected on Misery, he would have had it. He's actually chasing him down. X marks the spot is available, and support is on the way. Misery back to T1 tower. Now the X marks right on top of the tower, pulls him into the torrent. Innocence with the damage. The arrows are flying forward. No one's going to get caught by it. The curse is on Faith, but it's too late. From Soxa, Weeha wants to do something. Resolution's on the hillside, just watching his teammate die.
This is without Faceless Void. He's just up there happily farming top while DC have all five mid.
Just keep farming
toward this aggression. There is no downtime for Wings.
You don't need downtime. They just keep getting advantage after advantage with every minute that passes.
They're really finding their stride.
And they grouped up again to go for a smoke. They're under the T1 town, so yeah, they are. They really don't want to stop this aggression.
DC, they really need their Dezo out on Clinks to threaten the Roshan. They need some more items to get back in this game right now. All their cores are falling like flies. Wii's net worth is almost half of Shadows.
Misery. Luckily for him, he doesn't turn to the side. Unluckily for Soxa, X marks the spot, and once again, it starts in. Misery will not be able to get back there in time to help out.
The Cold Embrace has done next to nothing in this game, though. The Oracle Max Purifying Flames has just bursted hero after hero. Wings should claim another tower off of this.
Surprisingly enough, they commit Exorcism. This early on, they potentially could have been looking, honestly, to look towards a tier 3 tower when they're 17 minutes in.
The way the game has developed has been completely different from what DC have expected, though. Shadow maybe going for a Chrono on a Wii, but they wanted to just hold out the lanes. They have the spam with the Timbersaw, the Starstorm, the Winter Wyvern spam, but the way Wings are taking fights, it's not really at towers, or they're circling around behind you, splitting up, so they're not getting caught by the curse, not getting caught by too many multi-man burrow strikes. It's just a very chaotic fight where DC need order. They need time. They need Dezo.
I don't have time. They're fighting up against the Master of Time. Faceless Void. Like, he's getting controlled.
His time dilations have been really spot on. I was like, man, that thing's only level 1. It seems like it lasts forever.
Mm-hmm. Now, seems like Wings always know the Oracle did tell them how to play up against DC. If they can keep this momentum up, they could be looking at a 2-1 advantage in a TI Grand Final.
I think the bigger problem is that the Kunkka's getting far. You mentioned his early Tidebringer build earlier, and now he has an armlet complete along with the phase. He is becoming another core.
And the Blink Dagger on Death Prophet makes her almost an initiator.
Wow, she has Blink. That is a very unusual build for the Death Prophet, but I think it's really good because they need the position. They just need to be able to run on the back line, force Moran to use Leap, force Timbersaw to use Chain.
He's not denying the Sentry Ward, so it doesn't reveal his position. He knows it's there, but now DC smoke up, and they're coming for an opening. They're pinging and saying, I can see the Kunkka. We know they're headed down. There's no bottom runes. Not going to go that far.
Oh, the scam.
The sentries are down, but now Faith, he moves over. The sentries, he's out of range, but he actually just walks straight past him. Gets a double stun on Nu and Weeha. Blinks. Oh, no, he's stuck. He has to go invis for now.
They don't know where he is.
No, they don't. He's not even meant to be there, so they can't predict he's going to be there. Shadow will come over and free his teammate.
At least they have two Observer Wards in the area. They got something out of the smoke, and one is just out of range of the Radiant Sentry. So perhaps with this, Clinks can sneak in and take Roche. I don't think he's strong enough to take by himself, but maybe a Cold Embrace here and there will be enough to secure that Aegis. But more importantly, they need towers. I'd like to see some maybe backdooring speed off as a Lucian.
Blink stunned by Carapace. Sent instantly back that Starfall of Weeha. Shadow, he's there. Chrono's up. Moonlight Shadow will not protect the Marana.
No,
now bottom
there.
Lane because they found the Death Prophet. But Death Prophet, what? She blinked away. No one attacked
what?
Her. She just gets her out. She had the Yule Scepter as well with the Exorcism up. DC was, well, hoping to kill her up before it could do a lot of damage. Now she'll bring it back over, putting a little bit longer left on it. Timberstar up for Fate, gets the stun. Now the Exorcism goes to work. Misery prep in the epicenter. Throws right forward. Please going down with the fortress and the save is used. Resolution, time dilation out this fight. Sox has the TP out, but DC, they're losing everything, including the kitchen sink.
Wow, I can't believe that Blink Dagger just worked out for him so incredibly well in that position.
Yeah, sounds odd. Well, that's everything about Wings, right? It's unusual, it's different, and it works.
Yeah, that is the craziest part, that it works. That was a nice epicenter by Sand King, but they don't have enough damage not to take down Blink with the Rum and the False Promise. Like, it's just such great synergy, too. Purifying Flame, you don't even need to cast Faith Edict, because Purifying Flame only does no damage to you.
Alright, good team, tier 2 town now, bottom lane, going the way of Wings and DC. They are on the ropes, almost 10,000 net worth and experience behind. The graph just keeps rising for Wings.
And I don't even think that Axe is that game-changing for DC at this point. They have Faith Edict to counter it, but more importantly, Nyxed Assassin, you can just care Faith right in front of him, and it's been a hit on him if he hasn't had a creep. So a split-pushing Murano can normally get out of control and farm, but not this game. DC looking for a smoke.
Oh, it's like they're trying to contest a Roshan play from Wings, but Wings aren't in there. Instead, it's Misery, who's going to get initiated on by Faith Beyond. Shadow, Ashe gets a first hit, time lock, Misery into the Sandstorm, Barrow Strikes, but it's nowhere near fast enough. You'll end up going down the Fate time, not being his friend, and now DC Fate, he's so close, you can smell him! But he doesn't know! Timber will be the tank with the reactive armor, but blinking around, Shadow's in the neighborhood. A quick sentry down from the Wyvern will at least let them know if Nyxed Assassin wants to walk in, but Shadow initiating on the Wyvern, this is even more distraction. If DC can get this Aegis the Immortal, it leads to nice wings and extra life. Sucks is going to have to give his own life up for it, but Roshan down to 3.1 now. Slowly ticking. Murana's taking the top tier 1 tower. It's almost done. And Wings, a numberizer DC. They've pulled a quick one on him.
Very important for them with the Klinks. He spent so much time running around in the early game, he needed something to compensate him for his troubles. The precious Aegis goes his way, but I don't know if he's the only one left at the end of the fight. I'm still not sure about DC's chances coming up in a team fight. They just need to keep on split pushing, get some more towers to equalize this net worth. It's becoming close to uncontrollable with a 12,000 net worth lead for Wings.
Well, they need some other key items as well. Like the fact you've had no proper initiation from DC, Murana arrows don't connect, and until that blink dagger is over on Misery, he also has no joy. Resolution can jump in through the back lines, maybe that's going to be his fun key, but he's going a BKB build next, so he doesn't have an Orchid to control up the Oracle, which may have been his better chance. If either that or you force a false promise on Innocence. And now, here they come, bottom lane. Innocence, they see him behind the trees, no shadows on the lane, and there goes your first one. False promise, Innocence has to use on himself. Shadow, he can time walk off the damage. Chrono is still available, and Resolution, he's actually got no mana to work with, but Klinks, the damage is still enough. Thanks to False Promise wearing on. Misery, get the hell out of top lane. The fresh blink dagger will get him away from Faith, who has a blink and ether lens of his own.
And now the Klinks can start doing what
he does best. Caught by Chrono, stop the Siphon, or actually wait for it. The Cold Embrace, Weehaw, staying alive a fair amount of time, but then, okay, Exorcism Committal is real. They're looking for more, and they're gonna find it. Yule steps around, Timber hits the ground, starts with the Timber Chain over, Shadow taking heavy damage, and now Resolution wants to help out, but he put himself in harm's way. In comes your Epicenter from Misery, he'll Barrow Strike through, he'll slow him down, do a little bit of damage, but not enough. The curse, it's big on the Faceless Void, Resolution's back alive, give him some space, and sucks to caught on a cliffside, his Arctic Burn wore off at a very, very bad time.
The realm's wearing off, they have to back off now, and finally they get a Winter's Curse, which is especially difficult with the Lincoln Spear on Faceless Void, but no heroes die on Wings yet again. DC, get nothing. A penny for your troubles.
And a penny will not fuel a war. They have to find some kind of better opening. The Aghanim Scepter is now done on Weeha, but it's cost them a lot to give him that much space to get it. Klinks will also have his BKB, so two critical items arriving for DC. In fact, you can still say three after Misery picked up that Blink Dagger. So they have ways to surprise heroes. The Dire Observe Ward on Bot River almost scattered out Ice Ice. A little bit too far away as they can, Faith Bien. Rotating around, looking for an opening. Middle lane, Blink, Fire Strike, a Death Prophet, the arrow will connect. That's a good 5 seconds. Innocent getting ripped apart by Resolution. He took the False Promise onto Blink, but the life just won't be there. Blink is guaranteed dead when he hits the ground from the damage, and it will happen. Klinks will take the kill. Corner Brace keeping Misery up. Now it's Faith Bien's turn. Resolution finding a triple kill. Digital Chaos have just pulled out the team fight of their life. It may give them some way to quell the bleeding that Wings have been doing to them.
Finally, they kill the Death Prophet, even though the Oracle has been ever so vigilant sitting behind them. And they got caught without the Faceless Void. He has a very greedy build without a TP score on the inventory.
He's thinking about going in, he will. He'll Chrono over on Resolution. Hard to find the kill. Cold Embrace available, so is the curse. They're teaming up, actually really, really close together. And now Blink, Fire Strike. Misery tries to create more space. Resolution needs to wait for Ice Ice to hit the ground after Yule, and he will do so. Armor toggling his way out, but not enough. Murana was still there. The Aghanims giving the extra damage.
Not really respecting the Cold Embrace that time. Without the Oracle, they cannot burst through that. And that's four kills the way of DC.
How much does it swing? They had 14k advantage in gold for the net worth. It's going to come back down again. This will be a bigger momentum shift for Wings. They'll still have to get themselves back into the lanes.
The Void has to be the one to protect the Death Prophet at this point.
Do you think you can do this, Faith? He's looking at Misery in the tree lines. Misery can actually get body blocked in if he's not careful. He's starting the stun. He's not certain he wants to do it. The Faceless Void is on his way. Wait. Misery. Does he blink? Does he burrow? He'll get stunned. He'll get controlled. And he can't burrow out in time.
How many bashes does this guy get?
He only needed one, but he got two.
And even with those four kills, DC...
Oh, Resolution, this could be a good snipe. That courier went over the Observer Ward. It's got the rest of the Assault Cuirass on it. It's a Resolution. One attack is all it needs. 3,000 nanobit to spare. Net worth hitting the deck.
I'm surprised that Innocence hasn't gone for a Ghost Scepter with how farmed Resolution is. He is the biggest threat. They have a Sentry Ward, so they know he's in between the mid T1 and...
Yeah, that's why Isis is scared to death. He thought he was running down through the Ancients. Resolution will move up. He'll find Isis, but...
You can't
want
hide there. It's way too much fog for a Clink without Blink to jump in. Faces Void, Chronosphere coming off cooldown very, very soon. We see the first Ghost Scepter, possibly many, coming up on the Death Prophet.
One way to stop the damage from the Clinks, especially when he's going Chrysalis, not Diffusal.
But then it opens up for your Marana to do a lot of damage with the Starstorm, so they have to be careful about how and when they use it.
Very true. What kind of damage do you try and repel? Right, it's not like you can Fortune Tend to everybody, unless this Oracle gets to a point of having Refresher.
After those four kills, Wings only possess an 8,000 gold lead.
Nice Blink Dagger up. Now for the Marana, they're looking towards middle lane. Wing, smoke up, rotate around, the arrow won't connect, Hunker.
Death Prophet is not close by. Wings have to be careful not to take a fight while he's not here.
Oh, they're gonna walk straight in. Capern is on cooldown, Dust will trigger the blink! Misery! Evading the Chronosphere! He's fast enough for it. X marks his spot, trying to drag Resolution back in again. The arrows will fly forward.
With the BKB on him and no Chrono up, this is not the fight for Wings unless they pull them
You're
back.
You're under a Sentry Resolution, but now he's not. He's back far enough, right behind Innocence. Starts attacking. Bad! And now Timber Chain forward, move once more, Blink Barrow. They found Ice Resolution, putting that Chrysalis to work. They'll need one, maybe two hits. They'll hold him up. It's the cusp. Chakram, one attack, two attack, three attack, four! Resolution, where is it? Okay, now he's finally gonna hit the deck. The arrow will connect a triple stun. Misery will turn with one of his own. The Tidebringer! Ice will finally take a fall. Misery's too far out.
They spot out Shadow now. They ping out on it, but...
They'll walk under an obstacle to get to him.
Yep. I wonder if he's going to go for Bloodthorn.
I just want the T1 Tower. Resolution can easily take this. There's no fortification.
Yeah, that's more important than the Faceless Void.
You don't even need the creep wave. That's the beautiful thing about the Clinks. His damage output is just so quick that these towers don't stand a chance.
And finally, the supports of DC get high.
Oh, Shadow. Too close. Time walks up. They're on the chase. Weehaw. Arrow off cooldown in 4 second time. Leaps forward. Actually missing... I don't know exactly where he wanted to go with that.
Just maybe hoping he would TP down there and get an easy arrow, perhaps.
If he stayed on the hillside, he would have just been in the tree line. Nope. Another Blink Dagger coming in. This time, it's for the Winter Wyvern.
And Misery has dewarded all of the Radiant Wards with his shiny gem. And Roshan gonna respawn in. Wings probably pretty unhappy about the last way that Roshan went down. They don't have any armor items.
This can make him happy. Soxa just blinked himself down and put down Observer Ward into the Arctic Burn. He goes inside the pit, outside the pit, now starts to jump out. Where's the Torrent? The Fangs! It connects the curse, however, to the Wyvern. He still can't get down. He'll Cold Embrace by himself, at least some breathing space. As Wings, they commit the Cocoa's Run, they commit everything. A 5 second arrow will connect on Innocence, but, well, you kind of knew the Wyvern was going to die.
At least the arrow scouted out that there was no Roshan around. They see the Observer Ward right now. And that is the gem on the Knicks. So we have to huddle around on the pit. The Clink threat is way too much. And they probably have to commit Exorcism to it, though, which just leaves the Sand King in a perfect position to jump upon them. in the pit.
Do you really want to commit that much, however? Like, that's...
It's way better to find a pickoff, though, than going to the Roche pit. It's
true.
Far too risky.
It just delays you push high ground if you do it. Then there's no exorcism.
They're not really in a rush to take high ground, not with Kunkka.
Oh, this will be nice.
They find Misery. Misery, reaction, blink up. So got Fire Strike available. Gonna dodge even under the Sentry Wall. The Chrono Sphere! This is the gem of DC. Resolution wants to help out. The Nyx Assassin has gotten into the Chrono. He'll have to tank up the false promise. Resolution gets bashed up even on the first hit. PKB, another bash as well. He'll run away. Where's your curse? 6 seconds till it's off cooldown here for Tasca. He has to back out. Move in the neighborhood with the Chakra, making it difficult
for Wings to come down.
They don't have their gem carrier. Nyx had a TP home to get some extra healing from the False Promise in order to survive. Roshan gonna respawn in 2 seconds, but that is a big momentum swing. Wait, wait, he doesn't have the gem anymore. I think he passed it to Wing. Or Wing picked it up.
Really?
Pretty good.
You're right, it actually got on the Wing.
Yeah, I thought it was on Misery. I think, yeah, that's why he used the Chronosphere on him. Nice pickup.
And that was fast. Now it's DC. They still have a slight advantage, obviously being Dayasai with Roshan being up.
And their ultimates are up. Sand King, Epicenter still up, Winter's Curse not expended in the last fight. So they are ready. Chronosphere is still down for 40. I think this might be a time for DC to say, hey, come at us and Roche.
Nice new item as well for the Timpasaur, picking up a Yule set before this fight. So he's got some kind of escape or control against Wings.
And time dilation counter.
Mm-hmm.
Much cheaper than Lotus. That Observer Ward scattered out by Faith Beyond, but he
does not have a problem. The jump, the curse! Just as Death Prophet blinked himself over, the arrow will connect Nyx Assassin. False Promise will keep him alive, but for how long? Resolution pop a lot of damage. Shadow with a time dilation trying to force him out. Move the Cold Embrace, giving him more life. Yule set dropping towards the end. Nyx Assassin stays alive. The False Promise did its work. So it's only Mu to die. Weehaw! The leap, the blink, he's still up, but now he actually runs into Blink. He needs more time. He'll get the Starfall off, but Faith Beyond can be saved by this Oracle. The rest of DC are away.
First pick, Oracle, doing so much work when they can't lock him down. That is the Klinx's job. He has a lot of damage, but he cannot jump on the Oracle. You want him to blow False Promise on himself, and if he doesn't, he's going to die in 2 hits, like we saw on that fight top, especially if there's a lucky crit, which is going to happen a little bit more often now that the Daedalus is complete.
They need to bring the gem back. Is he in range? Can he not attack the ward? X marks the spot. Okay, yeah, now we go. Gem is in over and pop him. Some verbal ward will drop. DC does still have another big advantage. I say this is an advantage. They have no out of talent that Wings can easily just move over and take.
Yeah, despite the kill lead being 31 to 14 for Wings, they're only up 6,000 gold and forcing, spending a lot of time just running around, and also most of the DC's kills are on, or Wings' kills rather, on supports.
A lot of the kills for DC belong to Resolution. He's taken 9 out of the 14 of DC, and a Reflect in his items. I'm interested to see where he goes from here. Like, is it worthwhile getting that Diffusal Blade to get through the Ghost Scepters?
Yeah, I think eventually they're gonna get more. I don't know, they only actually have one on Death Prophet. Why isn't Sabium gold, so? Maybe not, that's a normal build, though.
The dewarding happened, so DC definitely know that Wings are around Roshan. They're gonna group up, smoke up. Remember, without the Exorcism, there's not a lot of quick damage arriving from Wings. So Roshan, at now 2k life, they're a little bit too far away here, DC. So Roshan will go down to Wings. The question is, they want to keep fighting. Sentries are down, leap up, looking for the Chrono. The leaps away, however. Timbersaw has to Yule Sash, he gets Yule Sash up, he's trying to avoid the time dilation. The Chrono! It got Resolution! That's a big one! They need to find the kill! Chips on the way, and a Resolution crashed on the hull!
Tasca also has to call him Embrace, but there's too much damage there to still find that kill. X Marker's back, Weehaw! Thought he might get out this one, the Epicenter arrives from Misery. Minimal damage, Wing can just tank through it. Misery, Silence, Nukes, he's got enough life. He's moving north, and will it be enough while the battle happens in the pit? Misery will die. DC lose 4 and Wings.
Wow,
that Chronosphere, that's one of those super high risk ones. It looked like two of them were right about to be on the edge, but he knows the range of that perfectly and catches one of the most highest priority targets. Klinx without a BKB. Lock him down with a Torrent on both to follow. No BKB, no Klinx, no damage.
That's the problem for DC.
It's a big problem because Whis not farmed enough at this point. He needs to be able to carry his own weight in terms of doing magical damage to their backline, pressuring the Oracle, but right now he's just unable to contribute because he's died so many times. He's died 8 times this game.
Yeah, it's not a happy game for Weehaw this time around.
And, I don't know, you mentioned the link is here, maybe not being the greatest this game, but look at Shadow, 11-0 and 12.
He does what's needed.
I guess the perfect chrono.
You're the perfect chrono, and you've still got the beautiful thing that is Oracle. Like, DC commits so much to finding one hero, and then all of a sudden, Oracle, he's giving the extra life over. We saw that from Shadow in the bottom lane fight. Oracle always had his back.
I also like the Lincoln Spear build because it gives you a lot of HP. If you go Vlad's, which is equally good for farming and sustain, you can just easily get bursted down by a double Starfall or Timber Burst or whatever it may be. But if you have that extra layer of 15 strength, then you can time walk off. Your Oracle has more time to throw that False Promise on you. You have more time for the Coco's ship to come out. Coco's Rum.
Mm-hmm.
DC's ready to go. You start Warcraft then.
You really want to fight into this if you're DC though, with the Aegis, with Chrono up,
not when Wings are basically reaching around and it's gonna come right behind DC. The scan comes down from Radiant Side, they don't find anyone in Viz, they know the Klinkt isn't there, and here they go, Blink triggers the Exorcism. They're on the tier 3 tower.
They wanted to be able to spam this with the Timber Assault and the Winter Wyvern, but they're nowhere close. The T3 is going to fall before they really get any damage.
Yep, now the jump comes in. Quick chain away. R3 blinks forward. Bar Strike. It connects with the Death Prop and the Chrono. We are a move. Shadow catches two again. The Tauren combo. They move down the Ward's Moon with a double thump from Faith. They ensure the kill. No buyback available for the Timber Assault. And Blink is still waiting for an opportunity. Resolution sitting outside the base. He does nowhere to go. Blink borrow forward. Blink takes some wears off, however, all the life kicks back into her misery. Caught out, another double stop from Fabian. The jump forward from Shadow, looking for the damage, and a time lock planted on Weeha. This could be it. A triple kill for Shadow. The cast is good, however. Nyxus hasn't been brought down. The arrow flies forward, missed his target. Resolution needs to pump in more damage. The gem stolen by Shadow as he'll run back out through the front lines. The Starfall dodged by the first Manta. Still hit by the secondary one as Klinks. Where is this control? Where is this damage? It just isn't there. The silence on Murata means he can't arrow. They see Innocence TPing out. It's going to be too late. The TP was more than well completed before the arrow reaches his point.
Man, Betty wish she had the Fusel now. The Ghost Scepter and the Oracle. Just popped out of nowhere at the perfect time. A clean sweep of the melee racks for Wings. Now, these Chronospheres from Shadow, he's really quick with those. They had no Zebra Ward in the base, but it just lined them up for a perfect impale after Nyxus, and Winter Wyvern had to blow so many of his spells to try and keep his cores alive.
I like how much Shadow doesn't want to go back to base, actually bringing salves out to himself instead of holding onto the gem, which is on the courier. I'll trigger the second one in a second.
I mean, he has Oracle on his side. He doesn't even need the salves, but...
Hey, when
gotta
you
get your farm up.
When you have a 15,000 net worth advantage, you can splurge a little bit.
DC trying to spring a trap, but the Manta Illusions looks like it's gonna scout out any shenanigans that DC can throw on this bottom lane. They can't go into the area. They know those wards are there, but Ice might run into it.
Yeah, he walks straight over. Misery, does he want to? Does he want to? He doesn't know. Oh, no! Misery! Misses the target. The arrow will also miss. DC, the tilt to get a Misery, just like screw it. Commit the ulti, but the ult steps are up. Ice running circles around DC's missed stuns. They're gonna lose more move. Actually, Chrono a little bit further up. Shadow's able to find him. Support will arrive with a stun in from the next assassin. It gives Shadow the time to get the hit. Weeha, as well as Misery. Misery doesn't actually have a TP scroll. He'll borrow strike forward. Weeha, no arrow available, so they're looking to kill off Innocence. But now the arrow will fly forward, but it's well off target again. Innocence, with so much confidence, stands his ground, and Weeha trying to predict he'll move back now as Shadow, again on another run, under the tier 4 towers of DC. They do not have a creep wave with him, but they can start a pincer.
Innocence might get picked up by Resolution.
Oh, can they do it? There's a Ghost Scepter. You can't pick off Jack. Yes, he can now. Diffuser Blade is up. Turns it off. The curse. It holds Death Prop in position. Shadow jumps over. But now he's in range of it. Weeha with the Starfall. Not enough damage. That to force off back to Winter Wyvern. Away from Blink. Coco's Rum well off the mark. And well, Misery is the stun there. 1 second, 2 seconds. Shadow double hit. Nice and quick. Finds the pick off on Misery. All he wanted to do is retreat.
Still alive and healthy on the side of Wings, and with no BKB on Sleek, they're going to have to hope for a miracle here.
Exorcism is down, however, a miracle's been eliminated. Move. There goes your shot from forward. Arrow flies in on target. Nice hit from Weehaw, but the better hit from Fancy Yarn. He has been godlike this game. Another big stun. Resolution. He'll finally bring down Blink. There is a spike canvas available. Resolution. No BKB charge. So he'll come up himself from Chakram, or he can just timber chain into Whirling Death. Gem can be recovered as Moo, hot on the tails of Ice Ice. Does he have the damage? Whirling Death. One punch. There it is. Moo gets the double kill. But the damage has been done. A full Raxing on mid and bottom lane done by Wings.
I think it's rapier time for Klinks.
I think he needs it. Moo, this will be godlike if he can get it for the Chrono. How much life has he got? Nowhere near enough. Shadow ripping him apart. There is no white flag on the door from DC. They continue to fight.
We thought they got in the game with a refresher up on the Death Prophet, but he didn't Yule himself in time. That's actually what killed him. The Klinks was just beating on him. It was very close to the Exorcism being returned, but didn't Yule, and then once she dies, everyone else dies around her. Luckily, they have a backup gem, I think, on the chicken.
Yeah, it's on the chicken along with the rest of almost the entire Shivas for the Death Prophets.
Resolution, I want to see that 6,200 gold.
He needs something. Yeah. The Relic is picked up on Resolution. He needs any kind of damage he can get at the moment.
Yeah, you want to be able to, like, one or two shot the Oracle, because the Oracle usually doesn't actually have the camera on himself. It's usually on his cores, and he doesn't have a Blink Dagger, so he's especially vulnerable to the Klinks.
With Resolution, he'll still have multiple problems, aka he's down to 4 Diffusal Charges, so by the time he can buy up the Rapier, he may not actually have any Diffusal Charges left.
Yeah, I don't think you can sell an item at this point, too, to get get the Rapier. You just have to farm out your 2,000.
Yeah, he needs to hold
buyback.
Everything yet. As an Orca build out from the Void, it's actually, well, one of the most expensive items in the game. The Bloodthorn is arriving for the Faceless Void.
Yeah, you can Yule off the time dilation, but then you're just going to get silenced up. And then the Marana has no solution, really, to the Bloodthorn.
And even that, like, you get an Agonim Scepter on the Assassin bottom lane. They initiate Ice Ice, they want the kill. The Sun is there on Misery. As Yule sets protect Ice Ice again. Misery forced up now. The double one. DC, they just need a bail out here, but Misery pulled back. Cold Embrace will keep him alive a little bit longer. Byron strikes up for him as the Chrono on the back lines. They found Resolution. It's a big kill. Moody to turn the damage around. Innocence to be ripped apart by the Chakra. And he will go down. The cards is too late. He will take the attention away from Wings. And now Epicenter. Misery will also jump in. Marana dies on the left. Misery, four staff out. Shadow, hot on the tails. Remember, this is DC trying to defend when they got two lanes of Megas up. Moo has to buy back, but there's no buyback for me or Resolution. So a hard fight now in front of DC. Exorcism will wear off. That's one upside for them. And Wings will back out. Even with the two cores, they're not going to push the envelope too far. They have the refresher off on Blink, so you have a second Exorcism if you want to push, but without all five heroes, it's just not worth it.
There's a gem just sitting on the ground. I wonder if they're going to try and pick it up with the chicken, but very close to DC's side.
And Klinks cannot get caught out like that. Like, if they can recover the gem...
I think it's more so like Shadow always finding the right targets with the Chronosphere. He knows that the Klinks is the only one that can really do damage to them. Marana's countered by the Fate Edict.
That Courier has traveled. The whole drop the TP scroll. Now the Courier on the Silence. Yules will dispel. Support's coming over. It's there for the Winter Wyvern. But with the Blood, it'll be enough. The Bloodthorn Timbersaw. He's not going to pop. They force up him out. Mr. Timberchainer! They pop him, the gem's on the ground, and there's no buyback. 80 seconds without the Timbersaw. DC, they're scrambling away. Soxa needs some help. Misery's there, but again with the Silence. Four star fuck. Nice arrow from Wings. Hitting Blink on the backline. They bar and strike forward. Blink is low with a splinter. It's not enough damage. Shadow the Crunch here. Resolution! He walked into it. The damage is there from Shadow. Resolution is gone. And with it, maybe the rest of the game changer. Wings will take game number 2.
What a god on this faceless boy. 20 kills, 0 deaths, perfect Chronosphere. Resolution trying to all in with the Bravery at the end, but no death pack, walking into Chrono, just a lot of mistakes from DC as they crumble in game number three.
Yeah, the big story is that bottom lane missing a stun after stun. You can see how DC, the smile turns quickly upside down as Wings have a flawless game, and you gotta say it, it's the way you do it, non-Melk style, 20-0.